In this video, we're going to finish off our study of the differential equation d squared y dt squared equals lambda y by looking at the case where lambda is bigger than 0. This is called the hyperbolic case. Now, before we get into that, I need to define the hyperbolic trig functions. Hyperbolic trig functions are called the hyperbolic cosine, COSH, called cosh, and the hyperbolic sine, SINH, called sinh. And those are just combinations of e to the x and e to the minus x. Cosh is plus, is the average of e to the x and e to the minus x, and sinh is half the difference. So you'll notice that cosh of 0 is 1 plus 1 over 2, that's 1, and sinh of 0 is 1 minus 1 over 2, and that's 0. Now, the derivatives of these functions, well, the derivative of sinh, well, you have to take the derivative of e to the x minus the derivative of e to the minus x. But the derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. And the derivative of e to the minus x is minus e to the minus x. So the derivative of the sinh is just cosh. Exactly the same as the way that the derivative of sine is cosine. Now, the derivative of cosh, again, the e to the x comes along for the ride. The e to the minus x switches sine. The derivative of cosh is sinh. So instead of the derivative of cosine being minus sine, the derivative of cosh is sinh. And this means that if you take a second derivative, if you take the second derivative of sinh, take derivative of once, you get derivative once, you get cosh, take derivative again, you get sinh back again. The second derivative of cosh, derivative once gives you sinh, derivative again gives you cosh. So these are solutions to the differential equation. The second derivative of the function equals plus the function. Cosine and sine were solutions to the differential equation. Second derivative equals minus the function. Cosh and sinh are solutions to differential. Second derivative equals plus the function. Last bit is you can go back and get e to the x by taking cosh plus sinh, and e to the minus x equals cosh minus sinh. So anything that you write in terms of e to the x and e to the minus x, you can rewrite in terms of cosh and sinh. And anything that you write in terms of cosh and sinh, you can rewrite in terms of e to the x and e to the minus x. Which set of functions you use is up to you. But there are real advantages to using coshes and sinhs. So now let's look at our differential equation. We want the second derivative of y is equal to lambda y, where now lambda is positive. We define a constant kappa, which is the square root of lambda. And so lambda is kappa squared. And that tells us, so our differential equation is y double dot is kappa squared y. Well, one solution to that equation is e to the kappa t. Because if you take a derivative once, you get kappa e to the kappa t. Take a derivative again, you get kappa squared e to the kappa t. Great. Another solution is e to the minus kappa t. You pick up a minus kappa when you take a derivative once. You pick up a minus kappa when you take a derivative again. The minus signs cancel, and you get kappa squared e to the minus kappa t. So, in fact, the most general solution is some constant times e to the kappa t plus another constant e to the minus kappa t. And that's a nice form for a general solution. So let's go ahead and try to figure out what these constants are in terms of initial conditions. Our derivative is c1 kappa e to the kappa t minus c2 kappa e to the minus kappa t. Plugging in t equals 0 up here, you get y of 0 is c1 plus c2. And y dot of 0 is c1 kappa minus c2 kappa. Divide both sides by kappa. So you got c1 plus c2 is y, c1 minus c2 is y dot over kappa. And you you solve those two equations in two unknowns, and you get what c1 and c2 are in terms of y of 0 and y dot of 0 and kappa. Trouble is, that's ugly. That's not a very nice, simple, intuitive form for what the solution can look like. It's this big mess times e to the kappa t plus this big mess e to the minus kappa t. Things come out a lot nicer if instead of working with e to the x and e to the minus x, we we work with coshes and sinh. So let's start over and say, hey, let's take our solution 1, and I'll put a 1 twiddle. We'll use twiddles whenever we're using coshes and sinhs. It's just cosh of kappa t. Its derivative is kappa sinh. Second derivative, kappa squared, cosh. It works. Well, it should work because it's just e to the kappa t and e plus e to the minus kappa t over 2. And e to the kappa t and e to the minus kappa t both work. Likewise, sinh works. Its derivative is kappa cosh. Second derivative is kappa squared sinh. So we can write our most general solution as some combination of cosh of kappa t and sinh of kappa t. And now we can figure out what these constants are. I'm calling them C1 twiddle and C2 twiddle because they're not the same constants as the C1 and C2 that we did before. Derivative, you just pick up the factor of kappa and cosh changes to sinh, sinh changes to cosh. And you plug in at t equals 0, and at t equals 0, cosh of 0 is 1, sinh of 0 is 0. So you get C1 twiddle is y, and C2 twiddle kappa is y dot. So that gives you what C1 and twiddle and C2 twiddle are, and now this is much, much simpler than the big mess we had on the last page. You put it all together, and there's your solution. Your solution at time t is your initial value times cosh, plus your initial derivative divided by kappa times sinh. So now what we're going to do is we're going to summarize all three cases. In all three cases, the key was to find a function that solved the equations with initial value 1 and initial derivative 0. For the case lambda negative, that function was cosine of omega t. For lambda equals 0, that function was just 1. And for lambda positive, it was cosh of kappa t. We found another solution whose value at 0 was 0 and whose derivative at 0 was 1. For lambda negative, that was sine of omega t. Now, that sine of omega t does not have a derivative of 1. It has a derivative of omega, so we divide by omega. For lambda equals 0, it was the function t. For lambda bigger than 0, it's the sinh of kappa t divided by kappa. And then our general solution is always going to be y of t is the initial value times that first function plus the initial derivative times the second function. It's just that the form of those functions is a little bit different. It's cosine goes to a constant, goes to cosh, or it's sine goes to t, goes to sinh. And with those functions in hand, you can solve this equation no matter what lambda is.